I want to say I appreciate Billboard for taking the light, taking the time to shed light on me right now. Because right now, you shed light on Houston right now. You shed light on Texas. You shed light on the few real leaders left. I'm one of the ones who represent the struggle and the less fortunate. And what I will say, when it comes to change, it's important. That's why this award is so important to me, man. It's important to change people's lives. It's important to change the thoughts of those who give up at times. And it's important to change things that wasn't designed for our best interest. For me, you know, I come from the streets. We got to protect our women. We got to protect our children. We got to protect our elders. It's time for us to change the narrative and control our own story right about now. It's about stepping up, not taking no for an answer. And if you know me, you know I never back down, and most of all, never give up. And I want to take this moment right now to dedicate this to my brother Money Clip D, my little bro Nipsey Hussle, my brother DJ Screw Big Hawk, all my SUC angels, my brother DMX. This for my niece Lyric too, you know Uncle love you, baby. And this for anybody who ever walked up to me and told me they was inspired or motivated by anything I do, man. I want to take this moment to say thank you to Miss Tina, Beyonce, Bay Good, you know, they whole family. It's times when people wouldn't stand for me, they always stood when others decided to overlook. And plus it's crazy because Miss Tina always called me a superhero, man. But Miss Tina, you know this means more to me than anything, especially to even be getting an award from you know what I'm saying? But what I will say, I'd be wrong if I wouldn't let them know. Right now, this for Houston, Texas. This for the HH time, we got one. We all won relief game. But one last thing too, Daniel Cameron, we still gonna need justice for Breonna Taylor.
Texas Third World Projects. And like, I just want to say, stop the ban on Trae Tha Truth, man. Because he is a man that done put in natural work, man, across the city, across America. And like, hey man, this man is a statement in the game right now without the radio. So that just goes to show boys on the other end that, hey man, you can make it without the radio. You know what I'm saying? But it ain't about that right now. You know what I'm saying? It's about coming together, man. Because God is good, you know what I'm saying, you feel me? It's two sides of every story, but I don't even care what happened, man. I just know that it's time to take the ban off the man. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, this man will help the homeless, you know what I'm saying, the elderly, you feel me? Back to school drive, done his homework in Congress, you know what I'm saying? And getting on in a major way, man, you know what I'm saying, with a genuine heart. You know what I'm saying? Big dog, I love you. You know what it is right here. Stop the ban at gmail.com.
This is about basketball. I have an important official announcement. This is very serious. Want to get this out. Message to Trae Young on behalf of the people of New York City and anyone who cares about actually playing basketball the right way. Stop hunting for fouls, Trae. I want to quote Steve Nash, a great player, great coach. He says, quote unquote, that's not basketball. Trae, that hawk's not going to fly in New York City. Come on. Play the game the right way. See if you can win. I think the Knicks are going to teach you a lesson.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Episode 26 of the Minority Agenda Podcast. I'm your host, Isaiah Thornton. To my left, we have the hip-hop encyclopedia himself. He is one half of the Luchador Tag Team Champions of the World, known as Minority Agenda Pod. And we also have the manager. He's the manager. He's the Jimmy Hart of the group, right? Yeah, you're the Jimmy Hart. You know, I was watching this documentary over the weekend. Yeah. But we have let me get to this guy first. We have Mr. Ricardo Mejicano. How are you doing, man?
So can we be like Sean and Marty Jannetty? You know, the Rockers?
Do I have
back to in the 80s?
Do I have to be Marty Jannetty?
I didn't say that. Oh no, how about Hawk and Animal? Legion of Doom. How about that one?
Okay. I'll take it.
Yeah.
I'll take it. That's fine. And then to my right, already, because Ricardo's on my left, right? Yeah. To my right, we have a man who, this guy's good. This guy is the reason why nobody on the Lakers, the Mavericks, the Clippers is getting fined. This man is the sole reason why LeBron was able to play. He's also the reason why Kristaps Porzingis only got a fine when they found out he was in the strip club 2 days ago. he's the sole reason. Him and Baby Luka. Shout out to Baby Luka more so than this guy right here. All right. And Laura. Well, shout out to Laura too. So to my right, we have Mr. Jacob Gray.
And more tune for your head top. So watch how you speak on my name, you know?
Yes, sir. What's going on, my guys?
We're doing good. How have you enjoyed basketball so far?
Oh man, it's been a great first round. I can't wait to see the end of it because like it's just you see the future generation coming in, and I can't wait till the old ones get out and we see what the new ones have to come.
I haven't missed a game yet. Surprisingly, I haven't missed a game yet. And this is probably the first time in a long time for a playoffs that I did this, not missing a game. Because, you know, when I was a kid, it'll be past your bedtime or you just fall asleep. But this one, I've watched every game so far. The only thing I didn't like last night was Mavericks were on NBA TV, same time as the Lakers.
Yeah.
That was annoying. But, hey, I got through it. I watched. I was clicking back and forth. And, man, Luka and Kawhi Leonard put on a duel. That might be the duel of the season. That probably was duel of the season. If you go back and watch each game, they had a duel. But
this year is the best year to watch the NBA playoffs because anything can happen, really. Yeah. Anything can happen.
Yeah, really good. So, gentlemen, we are here. We did a little I want to apologize for that long intro, but it was well needed.
It was a good intro.
Thank you. I appreciate it. We're a day late, gentlemen. We usually record on Tuesday and put out on Wednesday. But today we decided to record on Wednesday and we'll be putting out on Thursday. So happy Thursday morning to you when you listen to this.
Yeah.
Again, I said in the beginning, I want to apologize for that long intro, but it was well needed. If you listen closely, you heard Trae Tha Truth, you heard George Floyd, you heard Mayor de Blasio for the New York City mayor calling out Trae Young. And that's going to be some of our topics. But first and foremost, let's play respects to George Floyd. It's been a year, a whole year since the world, and you know, we can't say the world changed. I think that was the changing of the guard, will you say, when young people finally said, okay, enough's enough. We got to do something. We got to tear down buildings. We got to march. We got to do all this to get something done. And has something been done? A little bit. There's been a little bit of change. Not a whole lot, but Rome wasn't built in a year. America definitely wasn't built in a year. So we're moving forward. As a people, we're moving forward. In Texas, I think, you know, we're moving forward too.
I hope so.
Yeah.
You know, we still got a whole bunch of redneck towns, and I'm from one of them. But, hey, you know, you see a little bit of change every day. So, how do you guys feel about the 1 year anniversary? And I hate to call it an anniversary because it's so sad. But I do appreciate that the White House invited his daughter to the White House. I thought that was one of the best moments yesterday. So,
yeah, I like to think about it more the remembrance, you know, more than anniversary, you know, because it's not like it's not so much of a celebration, but just kind of like looking back at like what the whole year entailed and like just how being already part of like this huge, like ever-changing pandemic, you know, and then something like this happened and it completely like shifts everything, you know? Mm-hmm. So like where like, you know, it didn't matter about a pandemic anymore at that point. It was about, you know, finding, you know, the truth in all this and like finally being like fed up with like what had been going on for like so many years and I really taking a stand. And I mean, it's crazy. Like you said, it's not finished, you know, this isn't anything that, that has resolved everything, but you know, but it's a step in the right direction because with the conviction that happened earlier, a few months ago, I wouldn't call it justice, but it's definitely progression. So.
Jacob, did you have anything you want to add?
No, I'm 100% with Ricardo. Like it's progression. Like we're there, we're getting there, but it's not going to happen anytime soon in a snap of a finger.
Well, gentlemen, I appreciate you guys that much. Mental check. How are you guys mentally right now?
Mentally,
I'm good. I'll say
that. I'm straight. You know.
Okay.
Got work. Got other like just creative things in my mind that I want to achieve and start doing, whether it be like on this podcast or like other ventures, you know. So just a lot of thinking and brainstorming right now.
Okay, Jacob, how are you doing? How are you? We know
diapers. I'm here and there.
We know diapers aren't cheap.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Some days my mental is straight, and some days I'm losing it.
Understandable. Hang in there. First mm-hmm. and foremost, let's get to our first topic. The Billboard Awards.
Yes.
Hold on.
And more tune for your head top, so watch how you speak on my name.
Yes,
you
know? Sir.
Ah, decade. He was artist of the decade. Do I agree with it? 100%
deserved it.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. I can't argue that one. I was excited for Trae Tha Truth. I didn't know he was receiving this award. I didn't know this was going on. First and foremost, they didn't.
What was the award for? The one that Trey got?
Community, I think it was community. Let me look it up real quick.
While you, 100% deserves that.
Yeah.
If you follow Trey on like any social media, you see what he does for the community, not just like Houston in general, just for the Black community and the Black culture.
Yeah.
All around America.
And he's still banned. Still banned by his. By all the Radio 1 stations, right? I think it's all Radio 1.
Oh, he's banned?
Yeah, he's still banned. So like everybody, so all the radio stations that fall under the Radio 1 umbrella have him banned across the nation.
I never knew that. Why'd he get banned?
Because of the incident that happened at Trey Day where Sauce Walker, it was actually Sauce Walker's fault when he was still going at when he was going by AWOC at the time, he shot a gun. And because of that incident, they squarely blamed put the blame on Trey as mm-hmm. being the cause for like, you know, this incident. And because like that kind of like portrayed like a bad image, I forgot which radio station in Houston was the one that was like there, but because of that, they didn't want like associate themselves with that. So they put out like this massive ban. And it's been, but this is a while ago. That's why it's crazy that it's still like in play. This is like mid 2000s, 2009, 2008.
I wonder do they have Walker ban? Or is he not big enough at the time to get banned? So now he's big and they're just like, whatever.
I think at the time he was just a street dude, you know? Yeah. I think he was doing like some music. I think he was in this group called Mash Mode.
Yeah. He wasn't even a Sauce Twin yet.
Yeah, it was just Mash Mode at the time. But I think he was doing like some rapping, but it was kind of like, you know, half and half, you know, half in the street, half music. But like I said, it's just so unfair. Like you said, like everything that Trey has done for the past couple of years, that incident is so past him, but for some reason he can never escape it.
The award he received, ladies and gentlemen, is the Changemaker Award. The Changemaker Award for Billboards. This is the second time Billboard has ever given this out. And he was presented this award by Beyonce's mom. I can't think of her name. Tina Knowles?
Yeah, Tina.
Miss Tina Knowles. Shout out to them. Shout out to the Knowles family. Trae Tha Truth, he really puts on each and every year. I told y'all, was it probably like 5 podcasts ago when we had the snowstorm?
Yeah.
He was out that, like 3 days later, he was out buying gas and everything for people. I wish I would have known. I would have pulled up, but I looked at his Instagram too late. But shout out to Trae Tha Truth. He's always in Third Ward. He's always around the city of Houston and everywhere. So that was really good. The Baby also won an award. Little Baby won an award. Mm-hmm. Drake, like we said, Artist of the Decade. Shout out to him. And The Weeknd. I saw The Weeknd win some.
Yeah.
Billboard is just mainly geared towards the top artist.
The charts. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
I won't get to see OG Bobby Billions.
No.
Hey. I gotta retract the statement. I said Trap Boy Freddy was the best rapper in Dallas. OG Bobby Billions is the number one artist right now in Dallas. I gotta take that back. He's too good. It's too good. OG Bobby Billions, you go hard. But anything else did you guys want to add on the Billboard Awards?
I thought it was just funny on Twitter, all the Pusha T talk, just because of, you know, Adonis being there and everything with Drake was just kind of funny to see.
He won. Pusha T has won.
I mean, yeah, when your name gets brought up every time Drake and his son are mentioned, yeah, you've kind of won in some way. Just by having your name constantly in rotation. But I don't know. It sometimes gets a little bit played out. Like, it's funny, don't get me wrong, but I don't know how long it can... I mean, it's going to be one of those things that people are always going to mention, you know? Mm-hmm. I can't see people not mentioning it when it comes to, like... But, you know, they only bring it up when it's, like, Drake being awarded or, you know, being acclaimed for some sort of a success. So that, and, you know, they're going to bring it up because of that. And, of course, you know, his son was there, so, of course, people are going to... And that's the first time I think people have seen Drake with his son in like a public showing, like mm-hmm. like an award show.
Yeah,
he had the braids too.
I'm gonna be honest with you. I was like, who is this white baby with Drake? That's exactly what I said.
That baby is from the mountain of Caucasus.
He's a Slavic baby.
Slavic baby.
Listen, man. I tell you what. I think Luca can take him 1-on-1 right now.
I think it could too. You see this dark mark on my face?
Oh, right, we don't want to hear that.
That boy, he did it to me.
But ladies and gentlemen, there's another one-on-one battle.
That is going to be magnificent.
I've seen people already make their list of what songs should be played. Who's going to beat who? You know, when Soulja Boy plays Kiss Me Through the Phone and Bow Wow counters with Like Me. Listen, Soulja Boy versus Bow Wow. This is going to be the verses of the year, verses of the decade. This might be the best verses of all time, besides Gucci and Jeezy, because they almost fought. They almost shot each other in the club. Yeah. This might be the second greatest verses of all time. No doubt in my mind. I got wrong.
You just ready to see Soulja.
Yeah, I got Soulja Boy winning. Soulja Boy will win 15-5.
No.
I was going to say Soulja 13-7.
I was going to say... I was actually going to call it a tie, to be honest. I was going to say 10-10. I was going to say 10-10.
I honestly don't think Bow Wow has enough to compete with Soulja.
I don't know. Like, the Bow Wow hits, the one he's got, are up there.
But it's Soulja. Soulja has so many hits. So many. But I don't think the Soulja has, it's like, those features like that. I don't think he does.
He don't have too many features.
I think Bow Wow have a lot of features? I don't think... I don't even think Bow Wow has a lot of features.
He does. Like, I just think that when he plays, you know, Let Me Hold You, Fresh As I Am is,
yeah,
What's My Name,
Shorty Like Mine.
What else am I forgetting? What's a big one that I'm forgetting?
You think Bow Wow would play any of his old, like when he was a kid?
Yeah, What's My Name? That one.
Oh, yeah.
And Like Mike.
Oh, yeah.
The song on Like Mike.
That's what I was wondering, if he's going to play that one.
He has to. But
I think Soulja might win, like, off of charisma and, like, off of, like, stage presence and just being entertaining.
I think Soulja Boy is going to win because he's going to start playing stuff that he produced, which some people are going to say is unfair, but that's what he did. That's a part of the verses.
I feel like he even played his new song he came out with. What is it? Make It Clap?
Yeah.
No, that's a hit. That's a hit right there.
Ricardo, how you know it's a hit?
I just feel like it's a hit, man. I think it's a hit.
I don't think it's a hit, but.
You don't think it's a hit? What about the last one he dropped? What was it called? Hit My Line? Did you like that one?
I didn't listen to that. I didn't listen to that one.
I listened to Hit My Line. I thought it was pretty decent. I don't think that one was a hit, but I think it made some noise.
Soulja even has All The Way Turned Up as a feature. I forgot all about that. Bro, there ain't no way Soulja. I mean, Bow Wow's beating Soulja.
He produced that beat. He produced that beat, by the way. All The Way Turned Up.
Did he produce it?
I thought he did.
I thought that was K.E.
I might be wrong. I know he found Roscoe Dash. He did find, he discovered Roscoe Dash. But so I have it 15-5. Jacob, you still have 13-7, and Ricardo thinks it's going to be a tie.
I might even go up to 14-6.
Where are you getting this tie from?
I just think Bow Wow's going to pull out some song that we might have forgotten.
Does he pull out his songs with Snoop Dogg?
Yeah. I think he's not going to hold any punches.
Okay.
Bird Walk, Turn My Swag On.
And Bird Walk is Soulja Boy's second greatest verse.
You think Soulja going to play Booty Meat?
He should. He should.
Or she got a donk?
Yeah.
Yeah, you go, yeah.
He should play Report Card. He should be.
Yeah, he should. No, what y'all and Report Card with them together?
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I think they should do, Marco Polo, like we talked about last time.
No. They're going to end the show with that. They need to.
Yeah. The same way that Jeezy and Gucci did So Icy together. Yeah.
Marco Polo is Soulja Boy's greatest verse.
I don't know, man. I really like Soulja's verse on Gucci Bandana.
Yeah,
that was a really good one too.
But Ricardo, you see what you're doing? You naming our points. So I don't see how you have them.
Man, I'm forgetting about the Soulja Boy Lil B collabs too.
And then you're forgetting about Soulja Boy. Let's Be Real, where the song that got him banned by the army.
Banned by the army.
You forgot about that, huh?
I forgot about that. Yeah.
Soulja Boy's banned from the military. A lot of people don't know that.
I don't think he was ever banned.
No, he's banned. He cannot enlist.
What do they even mean? How can you be banned from the military?
He's banned. You heard what he said. Huh? You want me to pull it up and play it?
I can't remember the lyrics. Can you pull up the lyrics? I remember it was something to do with like the army, but I can't. It's been so long.
The man said F the FBI and F all the army troops. Fighting for what? Be your own man. That's what he said. That's what he said.
King Soulja.
And that verse, in turn, military people were firing back at Soulja. They were having their own freestyles on the same beat. And I was like,
in the barracks. Yeah.
In the barracks. You was there. Ricardo was there. Ricardo, you got a beat, don't you?
I don't.
You don't? Okay.
I really don't. Aren't you a big fan of King Soulja 3?
King Soulja 2.
King Soulja 2? That's the one that did it for you?
King Soulja 2.
Did it for
Don't do that. King Soulja,
he didn't need three. He had two.
King Soulja 2 was heat. All right. King Soulja was heat too, but King Soulja 2, where he had Giuseppe's. Oh, man. He had a lot of. Listen, when he was with Chief keeping them, hey, he was putting out hits.
He was putting out his hits when he was with them. It's facts. That's facts.
Like, Soulja would have been the game a long time. Ever since this Ice-T thing, he's been the game a long time. I knew he was going to have a long, outstanding career. And look, he's still here today. So, I'm glad they're going to let them do this Versus.
Is there a date yet?
There's not a date. I look for this to be like a July. I don't know, June, July.
I hope soon. I can't wait for this. This is one of like my most anticipated Verses.
Right. I think this should this be a Saturday night or should this be like a Friday night event?
Saturday.
Yeah, it's more like a Saturday.
Yeah.
Saturday night, you and your girl in the crib, and you put on Soulja Boy
and Bow Wow on Apple Music.
Hey, free trial. I'm rocking.
I already know Laura's not gonna know any of those songs.
You think so?
Yeah, I think she might know Crank That Soulja Boy. That's the only one she might know.
Who would Laura like to see in the Verses?
I don't know.
You don't know.
I have no clue who she would want to see.
Okay.
Picture this. Soulja Boy, right? They're in some sort of like they're hosting in like some sort of club. Maybe not a strip club. But some sort of club, right? You got SODMG in the back, posted up chilling. You got Jabbar. You got maybe A-Rab.
maybe
A-Rab. If they squash their differences, he's going to be there for Soulja because he knows it's SODMG to the death.
Yeah.
And then the rest of the crew. And like literally, you're going to have stacks on deck. It's going to be piles of money behind King Soulja. And then for Bow Wow, you're going to have like the so-so deaf, you know, entourage, whatever that may be.
Does he invite M to the K?
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe. No. You got to invite all the SOD artists currently and long time ago. You have to invite all of them.
And they're just going to stand there wearing the big SODMG chain. That's it. Or they can sit on the pile of money.
they need to bring back the Yums hat and shirt.
Yeah, they're gonna bring back the big giant Madden shirts.
Yeah,
and the sunglasses with the marker on it. You know.
Oh Jesus! All right, gentlemen, let's see. Let's go to one of my front page news. This is something new. I was gonna start the show with this, but I had to lead off with something spectacular. All right, let's see. What do we want to choose first? Uncle Luke does not make it to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I don't know how many times this is, but this is another year the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame has let off Uncle Luke. Jacob, are you familiar with Uncle Luke? I guess that's a no. Or did he freeze up? No, he's there. He's moving.
No, he's there.
All right. So, Ricardo, I know you're familiar with Uncle Luke. What does Uncle Luke mean to you?
What does he mean to me? That's a weird question. I don't think Uncle Luke means anything to me. I think the most, I mean, Two Live Crew means a lot to me.
Okay.
So I would say like, you know, as far as like that Miami sound, that bass sound, I really love that part of the 90s and like, you know, late 80s, you know, throughout the 90s because of like what, like, because it was so different from like what Southern rap was.
Yes.
From like what Atlanta was from Houston was. I mean, you can say that about everybody. Like, you know, Houston didn't sound like Atlanta. Atlanta didn't sound like Miami. Miami didn't sound like Houston because they were like the big three back then, you know, when it was very, very, very much underground. But I've always been a big fan of the whole Florida Miami bass sound, and Two Live Crew definitely at the forefront of that. So I would say Two Live Crew means a lot as far as that goes, as far as like production and like just having that super, super bassy 808 sound. So have they been nominated to go into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, like Two Live Crew?
I don't think so.
Because I know the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, sometimes they'll do group, but they'll also do solo act. So they'll put in the group, right? So some people get inducted twice. They'll get inducted as a group and they'll get inducted as a solo act. Like, because I think the Jackson 5, I think, are in, but Michael Jackson is also in, you know,
right,
as a solo artist.
My take on this was the parental advisory.
Yeah.
You know, he was the whole reason why you got freedom of speech in music, which, you know, he should be in. I think he should be in.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people think he should be in, but he's one of the founding fathers of hip hop, if we want to say that, and just making it more gritty, more of that sound, just like N.W.A. N.W.A. is in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
So that does add, you know what, I'm glad you asked that question while I look it up. Is Two Live Crew in? I'm not familiar with Two Live Crew being in there.
I couldn't remember. Maybe they are in already.
But we'll have to check.
But I can't recall.
Also on this topic list, we had something that I knew Ricardo doesn't know, but now he knows.
Okay.
SPM's son, South Park Mexican, son is now rapping. Did you know this?
I kind of did.
Okay.
So,
it's like a piece.
So sometimes I like getting on YouTube and trying to find like new SPM clips, like interview, because he'll still do like interviews from jail. But usually nowadays they'll be like YouTubers. So like YouTuber will get in contact with him. I think maybe through his daughter, Carly, which is the one that's been running Dope House for him. Like, well, nowadays, you know, I think when he initially went to jail, I think it was his brother that was running it. Mm-hmm. But nowadays, I think she's the one in charge of Dope House and like anything related to it. So I remember I found one recently, interview that I think he did maybe 2019, 2020. And it was crazy just hearing him talk like still in prison and just talking about how much he likes Whataburger and stuff like that. Like, it was the craziest thing. But yeah, I think in my search of like listening to an interview like that, I came across like his son rapping, but I didn't think it was anything he was doing actively.
Right. So I saw this clip. I heard his verse. His verse is pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Really, really good. I appreciate it. I'm glad he's moving on. I'm glad he's still doing the music thing. What I could find is on the Uncle Luke situation, I don't think Two Live Crew is in as a whole. I really don't.
Okay.
So he's trying to get it for him and, I guess, Two Live Crew. But, yes, but on SPM's son, yeah, it sounded really good. He sounded really good. So we'll see. Hopefully you can hear more stuff from him in the future. And then I do want to say this. Little Snoop's dad, Charlie Brown, he released a song over the weekend. He also has a music video with it.
See, I didn't know nothing about this.
I didn't either.
Yeah.
Is this to celebrate like Snoop's like recent anniversary, like of his passing or something like that?
It might have been.
Or his birthday. You know, what would have been his birthday?
It might have been that too, but it wasn't good. I hate to be the one to say that. I you know, you see how in the tone that I'm speaking.
Yeah.
It just, I appreciated that he did it, but I don't know if I would have made a whole music video for this and put it out. No, I just would have just released the audio and then leave it at that, because it just wasn't, it's not up to date.
So he just could have kept this, what you're saying?
He could have, but you know, where it was coming from, it was a good thing to do. It just, you know, like one of them things, like in my mind, that would have been a nice gesture, but nah, not now. So shout out to Charlie Brown, RIP Lil Snoop. I would have kept that. If I was on his team, I would have said maybe let's do something else. But it is what it is. And then my last two things on this list, Kevin Spacey gets his first film after a 5-year hiatus due to sexual allegations.
I thought this was crazy.
You thought it was crazy?
Yeah.
I'm going to be honest with you. I was like, oh, okay. I mean, I haven't seen him in 5 years. Maybe it's up. Maybe it's.
I'm surprised they put it out, you know?
Oh, the film company.
Yeah. I'm surprised they actually put it out themselves.
That's true, too. It's an Italian film. It's going to be an Italian film.
Oh, so he's been working overseas.
Yeah, yeah. He'll be overseas.
Wait, I thought he was in jail.
No. He never went to jail for this.
Was he charged?
He was never charged. Just allegations.
Because the last thing that came out while he was still going under the investigation
was Billionaire Boys Club.
Yeah, that one. Mm-hmm. Yep, and that was like released, like kind of like they were kind of hesitant to release that because of everything that just had happened.
Yeah.
And so, what's the movie called?
This new Italian movie. It didn't even have a name yet. It just
the new Italian movie.
Yeah,
it's just the new Italian movie.
It's a new Italian movie. It didn't have a name yet, but
that's crazy.
I don't know. You know, Kevin Spacey was a guy who was supposed to host, or he was you know being considered as a host for the Oscars at one point. You know.
Yeah.
So, in retrospect, this was a really talented guy. Just you know what he did in his past life in the 80s caught up with him. I didn't think it was crazy that he found a job. I see what your point is. I just didn't, yeah. You know, me, if he didn't go to jail and it was only allegations, you know, and it can never be proven, to me, 5 years sounds like enough time, right? Plus, we're in a popcorn media world. So people will remember that and then forget about it 5 years later. When I heard Kevin Spacey's name, I immediately went to his filmography and I said, wow, when's the last time he's when's the last time he's been in a movie? When's the last time he's been an actor? And realistically, the last thing you see him in was Baby Driver.
Yeah.
2017. If we're not counting Billionaires Boys Club, because I don't know when they filmed that. But
yeah, but that came out 2018.
Right, that came out 2018.
So that would be the last one.
Right, so that would be the last one that you see him on film. But if I go back even further, 2017 is probably the last time he's acted. You know, he's worked as an actor. So, it was really telling to me. And then, you know, you see a lot of people angry about this. I don't know. He's going over to Italy. It's not like he's going to be in America.
Yeah, and I think also recently we've been seeing the rise of like what I think some people are calling uncancel culture.
Yes.
Have y'all heard of this? Like, it's kind of like realizing that maybe some people went a little bit overboard when it came to certain people. Mm. You know, not to say that they weren't, not to say that they shouldn't have been investigated, because, you know, a lot of the allegations against Kevin Spacey were serious. But I think, you know, just like with anything else, you know, time heals everything. I think once people were able to like really sit back and realize like, well, damn, I think we kind of overreacted. Mm-hmm. They're able to like really just reel everything back in and be like, okay, I don't think it was what we initially thought it was, and kind of like start digressing. Cause you know, like I said, with the passing of time, people instantly forget, especially when it comes to like, just like with anything nowadays, like it's like something is big news today, it's going to be forgotten about in a week. So you can only imagine what 2-3 years does to like the human consciousness when it comes to like so many issues. Cause you know, there's so many things that come out every single day that it's hard to like care. You know, I can't think of a better word, but it's like how much is Kevin Spacey sexual allegation really affecting your life at the end of the day? You know, as much as you care about the victim,
right?
You know, if they were out there, because you know these are allegations, so we don't know if it was ever proven or not. That's kind of a personal thing, whether you believe it or not. But how much does that affect your day, and how much can you get past it at the end? You know,
that was well put, well said, Jacob. Do you have anything on Kevin Spacey? Would you like to?
Not really. I just have on like cancel culture. Like there is such thing. I'm with Ricardo. Like give it time, but like there's some things where the social justice warriors will go too hard on people and even like dox some people. Mm-hmm. That even if they do deserve it, you should never dox somebody. I'm just in general, like that could literally kill somebody.
Yeah.
And so with the whole uncancel culture thing, I agree that sometimes when people are supposedly quote unquote canceled, for, I mean, some people for like smaller things, all they have to do is just like own up and realize like you need to learn and just move forward from it
mm-hmm.
instead of just killing people's careers.
Yep.
Well said, guys. Well said. My last and final thing on my front page news. I have to play this clip. This is the mayor of New York, Mayor de Blasio. And he's a Knicks fan. He has to be. He's the mayor of New York. And yeah. He's calling out Trae Young, who I'm watching play right now. Atlanta's up 15-7.
Yes, sir.
And so, here, let me play this real quick.
Hey guys, look, I just wanted to tap in really quick.
Not that one.
Bro, I was like, this sounds like
this summer is it's
wrong. To be a white boy the wrong summer. White male.
well, you know, he wanted to let us know it's gonna be a white boy summer. Hold on.
Yeah, I don't know if Mayor de Blasio is gonna be participating in white boy summer.
You think he's with Chet?
Hopefully not.
Okay, let's see.
This is about basketball. I have an important official announcement. This is very serious. Want to get this out? Message to Trae Young on behalf of the people of New York City and anyone who cares about actually playing basketball the right way. Stop hunting for fouls, Trae. I want to quote Steve Nash, one of the great player, great coach. He says, quote unquote, that's not basketball. Trae, that hawk's not going to fly in New York City. Come on. Play the game the right way. See if you can win. I think the Knicks are going to teach you a lesson.
And a lesson they have not taught. Not even close. Not yet.
No. First point I want to get to. I love Steve Nash. Steve Nash is one of my three favorite players growing up. Like, I have two Steve Nash jerseys and everything. But when it comes to him saying that's not basketball, when he first said it, he's a hypocrite because when he played for the Suns, he did it all the time. And it's also funny that New York is calling him out when Brooklyn themselves, James Harden and Kevin Durant and Kyrie do it all the time. I mean, the whole league does it. You're just mad that Trae's doing it to your team and he gets away with it. I mean, Dwayne Wade did it to us in 06 and we lost the finals. So get over it, dude.
How do you guys feel about a politician giving his sports intake?
I like that.
I think it's funny, you know.
Yeah,
it's something different.
No, it brings character. Like it shows like you're not just political. Like some people might just want politics from a politician, and that's fine. But I like to see like a person side, like your what you like. Like if a mayor like cars. Say something about the new BMW that comes out.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not mad at this. I appreciated this. He did it while he had a Knicks hat on while he did it. I appreciated that too.
I like that.
And so, hey, you know, some mayors are liked, some mayors are not liked. In Dallas, I couldn't tell you the mayor's name. I'm pretty sure he's rooting for the Mavericks though. You know, we're up 2-0 in the series. I wasn't going to jump into sports, but we can jump into sports. We got like 10 minutes left. So right now, NBA playoffs are happening. Mm-hmm. The Mavericks are up on the Clippers. You know, we're beating up Kawhi. We're beating up Pat Bev. listen, Pat Bev is a little boy. He's a little boy.
Cannot handle Luka.
He can't handle Luka. It's okay. Wilson, you know, I've been talking trash to Wilson all week. Like, your team's not going to make it past the first round. You know, he keeps bringing up the 06 Mavericks to me talking about, well, you know what? You know, last time we were down 0-2, we came back and won in game 7. I'm like, that 06 team is not this team, okay? You're not going to compare, who do they have on the team? Dexter Pittman to Shaquille O'Neal. Like, you know, and Dexter Pittman's no longer on the team. I'm just naming a former Heat player that he hates.
So Wilson's a Clipper fan?
No, he's a Heat fan.
No, he's a Heat fan. He's down 0-2 to the Bucks. They got blown out the last game. Blown out.
Yeah, they got blown out. But, you know, he's always calling me. He's like, yo, 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 the Mavericks ain't gonna do nothing. I hope y'all beat the Clippers, but you know, y'all ain't gonna do nothing in the second round. Well, listen, it don't matter about the second round. We going to the finals, the Western Conference Finals. I want it to be Dame versus Luka. That's what I want. I know I'm not gonna get it because I don't know Dame. I don't know what Portland on. Portland not hooping right now. They got to hoop better. But yeah.
Hey, but I believe if we can beat the Clippers, we can beat any team. Any team.
I feel that same sentiment. I feel like the Lakers are not the Lakers of old. You know, not the Lakers of old.
Yeah, they're not the Lakers of last year.
Not even close. Andre Drummond is hooping though. I give it to Andre Drummond. I like how he did that last night. And the Jazz are frauds. The Utah Jazz are frauds. I hate to say it, they're frauds. All right. Shout out to Memphis. I hope Memphis keeps winning. I really.
I hope they win. I really hope Ja gets that. It's that dub.
Yep.
Any takes on your any sports takes that you guys have, whether it be football, baseball, what else is going on? Track. The Olympics is not going on right now. Oh, also, Ryan, I just interrupted you guys. Ricardo.
Yeah.
Ricardo, you asked me the other day about jambalaya.
Yes.
I haven't seen anything on Jambalaya, but I have seen something on Hot 97 Summer Jam concert.
Okay.
They're coming back in August. August the 22nd. Now, normally,
I'm not flying to New York.
Right. I know you're not, but I'm just saying, normally, they have their concert in May for Summer Jam, but they moved it to August, so we might see Jambalaya come back in August. Hopefully. I don't know. But since Texas is 100% open, you know, but I don't know how they would do that.
I was trying to get tickets to Austin City Limits.
What is that?
Yesterday, ACL. It's a festival down in Austin.
Okay.
I think Billie Eilish, the Baby, Erykah Badu, Stevie Nicks. It's a wide assortment of artists. It's not just like one genre. You know, it's very akin to like South by Southwest, right?
Right.
But not as big. And I could not get tickets yesterday. I was on that website. I was on my work computer. I was on my phone refreshing for like an hour straight, trying to get the tickets in the cart. No go. But I'm gonna try to see if I could get some resales. You know, try to get some good price on a resale. So I'm not gonna give up because the ACL is not until October, so there's still time. I can still. I'm gonna look on SeatGeek. I'm gonna be scouring the internet trying to find some good prices on these resale tickets.
That's
why I brought up Jambalaya. That's why I brought it up to you because I'm like, man, like it should be here by now because they usually do it like in like May, June, right?
Yes, May, June, late May, early June. Hopefully, you know, not when it's too hot, not when it's raining.
Yeah,
but August. August is going to be hot if they decide to do it in August.
Yeah. And like speaking of sports, man, I think I might have to go ahead and like cop like a Mavs ticket soon.
Oh.
Because I've only been to one Mavs game ever in my life. I think I might buy a ticket, you know, go catch a game, especially if once they move to the second round, you know, if especially if they're playing at the Trailblazer, because I would love to see Dame alive.
Yeah.
That'd be crazy.
If my family still had our season tickets, I'll take both of y'all, but we didn't get them this year because of the whole COVID thing.
Ooh. No, I'm definitely going to splurge. I'm going to buy a ticket. I'm definitely going to go see a home game.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. One more. Oh, wait. Hold on.
But that's it.
Okay, I was muted. Gentlemen, new music. This is our last topic, folks, and we're going to be out of here because I got to get a front row seat to watch the Knicks. And a whole bunch of other stuff. But I'll say this. New music is out. Go cop it. Go listen to it. Hefe yes. Strong. Hefe
Olivia
Strong.
Olivia Rodrigo, hey. Too.
Talent and Drugs. Wait, what?
Olivia Rodrigo's album is out.
I've been meaning to ask you about that. Who is that?
She's that girl with that song, Driver's License.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I listened to the album. It's pretty good. It's good.
All right, I'm gonna do you like Northwest did Kim Kardashian? No, you didn't. You know, why are you lying to these people? You didn't listen to that.
I listened to it.
You listened to it. All right.
I listened from track one, Brutal, to I Hope You're Okay, the last song.
Okay.
it's very like it's very much made for like a 16-year-old suburban girl. But I mean, the songs are good. You know, good music is good music.
So a 26-year-old Latino man should not be listening to this song. Huh?
I'm a little bit older than that, but we'll keep it at 26. We'll keep it at 26.
All right.
Yes, it's very poppy. It's very very young. Yes, but I thought it was cool. But yes, besides that, Hefe Strong,
Talent and Drugs. Hefe Strong, Talent and Drugs is out.
Yes.
YG and Mozzie Community Service album is out.
I still need to listen to it. I got it on my queue.
I listened to the first track. It sounded really good. I'm trying to see. I'm gonna refer to you, Ricardo. Are we familiar with Mozzie? Should I know Mozzie? Have I heard Mozzie on YG's albums before?
Has Mozzie been on a YG album? I feel like he has, but
That's what I was wondering. I've heard his voice. I just can't think of where.
Mozzie's from Sacramento. He's collabed a lot with not YG, but who am I thinking? He's done things with like God, what's that Cambodian rapper name?
Cambodian, see?
Yeah, he's out of Long Beach.
He's out of Long Beach. I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, I know who you're talking about.
God, I can't remember his name. But him and Mozzie got a big song, Mando. That's the name of the song.
Yeah, yeah.
Mozzie's on that one. Mozzie collabs with a lot of people though. He's done stuff with like Maxo Cream. He's done, of course, a lot of California rappers. With his Shoreline Mafia, I know he's done stuff with them.
Right.
I know he's done stuff with. I think he's
Stupid
done
Young.
Stupid Young. That's what it was. Stupid Young. Thank you. I know he's done stuff with like Vince Staples. Like Mozzie's all over the place. Like he's from Sacramento. Okay. So you know, Sacramento doesn't really have a big music scene. So he's like the only one really putting on for the city.
Right. Then we have Young M.A. off that Yak, her album. Have not heard it, but shout out to Young M.A. I supported Young M.A. when she first came out. She was really dope. Then you have Kirk Franklin. You know what? We have a mix that I thought I'd never see.
Ever, for real, ever.
We have Kirk Franklin and Lil Baby, I Win.
But this song right here? This song is crazy.
Okay.
I love it.
You love it.
The Just Blaze beat? Insane.
Just Blaze?
Yes, exactly. I lost it. Soon as I heard the beat, I heard, you know, the choir is good. Beautiful gospel choir. Baby rapping on it. You know, nothing too crazy, but, you know, it's a Kirk Franklin song. You're not expecting him to go insane. You know, he kept it godly as he could.
Okay.
I thought the song was good. You know, I think for what it's going to be a part of, as far as it being like a song for the official Space Jam A New Legacy soundtrack, I think it's good. I can see why they would include it on the soundtrack.
But Ricardo, that's not the best song that came out this weekend.
I'm not saying it's the best song. I'm saying I love it.
But that's not the best song that came. You know what song came out this week, Ricardo? Don't say it. Here, let me just play the audio.
Hold on, hold on, hold on.
You want to think?
Say it.
You want to
get Carisha? Carisha?
Hold on. Wait. It's time for the circulator.
I'm going to shake what my mama gave me.
I'm going to shake my money maker. The city girls are back. Hey.
It's time for the circulator.
It's time for the circulator. It's time for the circulator.
Jay-Z, I'm fly with it. C-I-T-Y with it. Right cheek, left cheek with it. Fun size on fleet with it. Slim, thick, petite with it. G-Wag with the key missing. One side for my freak bitches. After hour, no sleep bitches. When I get my freak on, they throw them.
All right. JT's here. The city girls are back. It's time for the twerculator.
I like the song. I do like the song.
You like the song?
I ain't finna front. I like the song.
Is it the song of the summer?
Probably. If it can beat up, no, wait. I think the song of summer is actually, and I know Jacob's probably been listening to this, His and Hers, Don Toliver, Uzi, and and Gunna.
So that's I haven't been listening to it, but my boy. So I'm in Discord every day talking to my boy. He's like, because we're doing different things while we work.
Yeah.
And my boy, he's at home and he streams like games and he plays His and Her on our Discord like 5 times a day, dog. He loves that song, but it is a pretty good song.
I like the song a lot. I think that could be song of the summer.
Yeah.
For sure. But I think Twerk Later is definitely, yo, it's gonna be huge.
Hey, I like Twerk Later.
Twerk Later's gonna be crazy. Like I like JT. You know, as much as I don't love her as much as Isaiah does.
Isaiah, JT.
But JT is great. Young Miami, Carisha, she's cool too. Listen, but yeah, man. I'm excited.
Listen, man, the City Girls are back, man. I never doubted them. I know I said on this podcast that they was done, they was finished, but I was beefing with Uzi. Now my beef has gone up with Uzi. Listen, JT, if you're watching this, you did amazing. It was great. All right, I'm here for the Twerk Later. You know, they waited for this song to be cleared for like 6 months, 6 or 5 months. I've heard this beat a long time ago, and there's this song a long time ago. They just never got it cleared. QC finally got it cleared. Now it's out.
When did you hear it? Were you listening to a City Girls IG stream? They're previewing tracks.
Hey man, don't do that. Don't do that, man. Listen, I probably accidentally went in and heard the live leak. But yeah,
okay,
yeah. No, it's really good. Song of the summer. I don't know about that one yet. I feel like there's a bunch of songs we haven't heard that might come out. Little Baby, I Win. That's not a song for the summer, huh?
No, it's not. Pushati dropped the deluxe for Shasta Season.
I seen that. I didn't write it down. I didn't know if it was an album or the mixtape. So I just.
It has four new songs on it.
Four new songs. Hold on real quick. There is something I should be playing. Wait.
It was cool. But I mean, if you heard the original, I mean, it's pretty much what you already expected, plus a little bit more. Mac Hominy, Pray for Haiti. If you want more into that underground gritty stuff, definitely check that out. And Currency and the Alchemist.
Right.
They finally re-released Covert Coup, which came out 2011 originally. So that is finally on streaming services. So if you're a fan of Currency and you were there when that mixtape first dropped in 2011, then you know what it is.
So, guys, we beat an hour. We are at 57 minutes right now, and we'll just let this play out. But I want to say this: all this new music, the summer's coming up. You know, everybody's in a good mental space. Bobby Smarter is gonna be coming out with some music soon. I don't know when, but it's gonna be soon. Also, the Crew League, I think is done filming. And so I don't know how long it's going to take them to edit that and put that out. I expect that to come out in August, maybe. Probably August. And then they also had Bobby Smarter as a guest appearance on there. But Jacob, is there anything else you want to say over this week or anything in the future that you want to predict over these NBA games?
Mavs sweeping 4-0.
Mavs sweeping 4-0. Okay. Should Luka get a shag?
Yes. I see. You seen those videos? I mean, those pictures going around on Twitter?
Yeah,
I love them.
Yeah. So Jacob thinks Luka should get a shag. Also, shout out to Unfiltered Media. That's our platform for the moment. Shout out to Wilson and his Unfiltered Media group.
Yes.
I can't say this on air, but I'll wait for that. I'll tell you guys off air. But yeah, Wilson. Yeah, you guys are gonna be out the playoffs by the time this episode drops. All right, it drops tomorrow, so you're already out. And I just want to say, shout out to Ricardo. Shout out to Veronica. Ricardo, anything else you want to say?
Drink more water. Recycle. Listen to music that it challenges you, that doesn't challenge you, and that just, you know, puts you in that vibe, bro.
Yeah.
Okay.
For real.
So
that's it.
Also, Ricardo, what is this beat, real quick?
Oh, this is the Action Bronson Riff Raff collab, A Bird on the Wire, produced by Harry Fraud. A classic, in my opinion.
Shout out Harry Fraud. Always get some good beats.
And I just want to let people know, like JT said, these rich men are throwing paper. It's time for the Twerkulator. So, Ricardo, go ahead, take us away. Jacob, take us away. I guess you guys can say it in unison. I don't know.
Now
we know what it is. We're not black. We're not white. We're something in the middle. This has been Minority Agenda Podcast, and we are out.